And this is pound for pound boxing.
The voice of a new generation.
We pull back no punches.
Fight predictions for the month of November.
What we're going to talk about is the beginning part of November and the results from the end part of October. So if you have any comments or questions or want any of these fights elaborated on, feel free to email us at p4pmail@yahoo.com or at our youtube.com. Here we go. Results. Ben Taggi versus Alfonso Gomez. Gomez comes out with the decision.
Gomez looked very sharp in this fight, and I'd like to see a couple more fights before he steps up to the upper echelon of this.
Definitely. He definitely showed in this fight that he's a contender in this weight class. Don't sleep on him. He's taking step by step, and he's winning his fights. So definitely watch out for him. I mean, a kid that was fighting against 160-pounders on the contender show, and now he's fighting at 147.
That's correct.
And he's beating up these people, two weight classes below him. Arturo Gatti, Ben Taggi, taking on,
sharp combinations, good head movement. That's a good decision.
So, Gomez, good lookout, man. Congratulations on your win. Mora versus Ayala, a draw.
A letdown for me. An embarrassment for Mora, and he even said so himself on BoxingTalk.com.
Yeah, definitely. What Mora, just step up your game, bro. You ain't got to be fighting all these name guys or nothing, but just stay active, man. Maybe 3-4 fights a year, that'd be great to see out of you.
Shake your ring rust,
you put your name out there in front of the people to see again. Juan Carlos Gomez versus Oliver McCall. Juan Carlos Gomez with a 12-round decision. As predicted, he needs to start stepping it up with these bigger names.
Definitely. He has an opportunity now to come into the heavyweight division and make a name for himself. Go out there and do it.
Exactly. Start taking also take one of these Russian guys and start fighting them. You can definitely make a name for yourself in this division. Felix Sturm versus Randy Griffin, a draw, another draw.
Let down as well. Felix Sturm was coming back from behind in this fight just to pull out the draw, and he was happy. He was taking pictures with the other guy, having a good old time with his belt. You didn't win that belt. That belt was just given to you because you're the champion. I'm telling you right now, you got to do a lot more.
Definitely. You can't be waiting till the last minute to try to come out with a victory. Your victory was the fact that you got a draw. Remember that next time you fight.
A true champion is motivated by every fight, not just the big fights.
Next fight, Jesse Brinkley versus Isaiah Henderson. Brinkley comes out with a TKO in the first round. Congratulations on your victory. You need to start stepping up the opponents. At least somebody with name recognition. A little bit something. Give me some substance, buddy. Okay, next fight, Vic Darchinian versus Federico Kutabe.
We had one of our YouTubers decide to email us and say that he wasn't that impressive in this fight, and that he barely pulled it off with a win at the very end. So, I really want to see the fight. I haven't got to see the fight personally, but I'll do a little bit more research and see what we can dig up on.
Definitely. I read the same email. Thanks for giving us the email. Sorry we can't remember your name right now to give you your props. But, definitely, Vic Darchinian apparently didn't do so hot. At the end, he did get the knockout. I watched the fight. We'll reserve for comments for later. Upcoming fights, Kasim Uman versus Saul Roman.
I'm going to go with the punching machine of Uman.
I'm looking for Uman to win that one, too. Joe Calzaghe versus Mikael Kessler.
Well, these two guys are putting the platform in front of the world, and we've already stated Joe
Calzaghe. Enzo Macaronelli versus Muhammad Alzawi.
Enzo by knockout.
Enzo by knockout in the late rounds. Juan Manuel Marquez versus Rocky Juarez.
I'm going to go with the guy who's in our pound for pound list, Marquez.
Definitely Marquez, and don't sleep on Rocky. He's still a good fighter. This one's more of a hometown fighter for us, and we're going to give him props because he trained us when we trained in Jarrell's gym in Savannah, Georgia. That is Al the Quiet Storm Seeger versus...
Al.
Versus Mike Oliver.
I'm going to go with Al rolling on this one, baby. He's going for the IBO championship. This is your second vote at it. His first go at it was against Daniel Ponce de Leon. He got knocked out in that fight. Overmatched because De Leon is a beast. But you know what? I'm getting a good prediction on this one. I think he's going to take Oliver in this fight.
Al, good luck, man. We're rooting behind you, Savannah, Georgia, all the way. Next fight, Jim Mark McCormack, Mormack versus David Hay.
I'm going to go with the UK guy right here. He's got speed, he's got skills, and I'm looking for him to showcase his skills right now in this fight.
Definitely. I'm going with the youth over experience here, and definitely that isn't David Hay. He's got great power punching, and he's fast, and It's a big step up. It's his step up, but don't sleep on Mormick, because Mormick is definitely a great champion. He's definitely been there for a while, and he's there for good reason.
There, no doubt about it.
Okay, the next one, another fight that we talked about a lot, Miguel Angel Cotto versus Shane Mosley.
Just check out the previous show, you can see what we've thought about this.
Definitely, we're going for Cotto, I think by decision.
Decision.
But we're not saying that Shane Mosley is garbage, so please, guys, stop with the hate mail saying that Shane Mosley is some kind of a guy. I'm sorry that y'all got y'all panties in a bundle, but, you know, all we said was Cotto was going to win. Shane Mosley, he's a great fighter. We're just going with youth in this fight.
That's it.
So, not to say he's garbage. We didn't say Shane Mosley's garbage. Joel Casamayor versus Jose Santa Cruz. I am saying this. Joel Casamayor is garbage. I don't like you, but you're going to win the fight. Congratulations, WBA,
WBC.
WBC ranked Cruz for you. Congratulations.
Cruz couldn't even rank in any other.
Congratulations to you. We all know you're going to win this fight with Teridu. Okay, Antonio Valladito versus Golden Johnson.
Only thing golden about Johnson is his age. He's out of his prime. I'm going to go with Margarito.
Definitely Margarito all day long. A much well-deserved fight after his loss to Paul Williams. So congratulations for your easy fight. Pass, go collect $200. Victor Ortiz versus Carlos Maza. I'm going for Victor Ortiz. I just don't like Carlos Maza. I don't like his style of fighting. I think his lazy eye probably doesn't get to see that the punches coming that well, as was the case with Cotto. And who was the other one he fought? Hatton. So I'm looking for Victor Ortiz all day long on this fight.
I'm a roll with experience in this fight. I think once you're in a ring with someone like Miguel Cotto and Hatton and Vivian Harris, I think you got a little bit more experience. I think that this new kid, Victor Ortiz,
he lost to Cotto, and Vivian Harris who?
You learn from your defeats, okay? That's all I'm going to say. And, so I'm going to go with
that. And I'm disowning you. Now, moving along, we're talking about stuff that happened in the news lately. We got Berto talking smack about Judah. Berto, don't call the devil because you will get the horns. And Judah can definitely beat you if you keep fighting the way you were fighting against David Estrada. I don't see you doing any damage to Judah, and I see Judah doing all the damage to you.
When Judah lacks here, he doesn't lack here. He's very sharp. He's very crisp with his punches. And Berto, if you're taking punishment the way you were doing it with David Estrada, you're going to get hit.
Exactly. Next one is Kessler saying, I got hurt hands. Or at least that's what's been speculated on the net. Kessler, don't be making excuses early in the fight, man. I mean, I know the pressure and all this. If you got hurt hands, pull out the fight. Vargas did it. Who else did it?
Heavyweights and everybody.
Everybody and their mama's been doing this in September. So if you got hurt, just say you hurt, pull out the fight, keep it moving.
Don't try to say that you're a champion. Oh, I fight through this. No, none of that. Because once you get beat, you're going to be saying, oh, I had hurt hands. I don't want to hear that excuse. I want you to go in there, and if you don't have hurt hands, fight the man. But if you have hurt hands, pull out.
Exactly, and same with you, Cal. You saying, oh, this might be my last fight. Don't be making excuses early now saying that you want to retire, this and that. Fight, make it a fight, go in there and win, and do the damn thing. We still rolling with Cal Zaghi. Moving along, Shane saying that he's going to KO Cotto.
You know, this is the thing that I was saying earlier, that this is why Shane has fallen to his opponents. Last couple opponents he fallen to, Winky Wright and Vernon Forrest. And both times, what did he say in those fights? He said he was going to knock out those guys. And this is why, that's his falling. This is where he falls every time. When he's looking for that one punch knockout, it never comes to him. And that's what his mistake is in this fight with
Cotto. So Shane, stop trying to look for that one big punch. How about you try using the combinations that made you so pretty and early in your career? That, my friend, will get you the victory.
No doubt about it. That's what made you stellar from the beginning, from the get-go, was his beautiful combinations, laser-sharp, razor-sharp combinations. I mean, just power.
Definitely. And that's our show for this week, guys. Thanks for all the comments, the subscriptions, for everything. We appreciate it all. If you got it, if you want anything recapped or anything elaborated on, p4pmail@yahoo.com. And that's our show for today, guys. Until then, this is Pound for Pound Boxing.
Voice of a new generation.
We'll pull back no punches.